All right, this is fifth grade, module 2, lesson 4. And in this, we're going to be using some visual strategies to help us understand some mental math here involving multiplication. All right, so for example, so we have the problem 37 times 19, and there's a lot of ways that we can think of 37 times 19. One, we can think of it as 37 19s, as in 19 plus 19 plus 19 plus blah, 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 forever and ever and ever. So we're being told to circle each expression that is not equivalent. So this guy, he's equivalent. So I'm going to cross him off saying, well, he's cool. And now this one, this next expression here, we have 37 19s, all right? And we know that from right here, 37 19s. Well, if we were to take 30 19s and add it to 7 19s, so if we had 30 times 19 and add 7 times 19, that would be cool because that would give us 37 19s. But this guy is no good. It's nothing even close. In fact, I kind of think that 29 might even be a typo, like it should be a 19 instead of a 29. So we're going to definitely circle that second one because it is not equivalent. Going on to the third one, well, if we had 37 times 19, so 37 times 19, well, this guy is definitely equal to 37 times 19 because 20 minus 1 is 19. 20 minus 1 is 19. So this guy is equivalent, so we're not going to circle him. So just so that we don't get all confused, I'm going to cross him off. And then the last one, we know that we want it to be equal to 37 times 19, but this right here is 38 times 19, so this is also not equivalent. So the two ones that we're going to circle because they're not equivalent is the second one and the fourth one. Now here we're going to be solving using mental math, but we're going to use a tape diagram to help us understand how to think about this mental math. For example, 19 times 50, we're going to think of that as 19 50s. So that would be like 50 plus 50 plus 50, blah, 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 19 times, all right? In fact, that's what this tape model is right here. This is saying that you've got a bunch of 50s all lined up next to each other, and that, in fact, we even, to make our mental math easy, we think of it as 20 50s, because 20 times 15 is way easier. 20 times 50 is way easier to do in our head than 19 times 50. And then, so we've got 20 times 50, and then because we've multiplied 20 times 50, and really we only need 19, we're going to have to subtract 1 times 50. We're going to subtract an extra 50 because we multiplied 20 times 50 instead of 19 times 50. Now we could do the math really easily in our head. This is 1,000. And then 1 times 50 is 50. And then 1,000 minus 50 is 950. All right. Let's try problem B. So 11 times 26. We can think of this as 11 26s. Well, 11 26s, there's a lot of different ways we could think of our mental math, but they're kind of guiding you towards one way of doing it, which is we could think of this as 10 26s plus one extra 26. And then, so that's going to be 10 times 26 plus 1 times 26. So this is 260 plus 26, which is equal to 286. Now, folks, if a student has a different way of thinking of this, maybe a student says, hey, I really, really understand 11 times 26 as being 5 26s plus 6 26s, and that's how the student wants to do it, more power to her. That's okay, because the beauty of mental math is there's a lot of different ways to do it. You don't all have to agree and do it the same way. But I think I did the most common way, which is 10 times 26 plus 1 times 26. All right, and actually, it looks like I forgot to draw the tape diagram. So let me go in here and draw in that tape diagram. And that tape diagram would, it says 11 times 26. So really, we have 11 26s. So really, what they would want is a 26, and then another 26, and then another 26. And we'd keep going all the way until we have 11 26s. And that's essentially what the tape diagram would look like. Now here is kind of more of the same. We're going to just, without using the tape diagram, without using that visual. Oh, by the way, I think I forgot the visual on the other one. I'll see if I could go back and add that. Anyway, on this one, 29 times 12. So we're going to think of that as 29 12s. So we're going to be thinking of 12 plus 12 plus 12 plus 12, 29 times. And a nice easy way of thinking of that would be thinking about 30 12s minus 1 12, because 30 is too much. So we're going to take away one extra 12. So that would be 30 times 12, and then we're going to take away 1 times 12. So 30 times 12 is 360, minus 12 gives us 348. All right, let's take a look at number B, 11 times 31. So we're, for some reason, they've decided for us to think of this as 31 elevens. We could have thought of this as 11 31s. But they chose to kind of guide us towards 31 elevens, which can be thought of as 30 elevens plus 1 11. So that'd be 30 times 11 plus 1 times 11. So that's 330 plus, oops, not 33, 330 plus 11. And that gives us 341. Last slide here. And on this last slide, Joy is helping her father to build a deck that measures 14 feet by 19 feet. Find the area of the deck using a mental strategy. So the first thing you're supposed to remember is that if you have a deck that is 14 by 19 and you're trying to find the area, that means you're going to do 14 times 19. All right, so my mental strategy, and a lot of different ways to do this, I'm going to think of 14 times 19, and I'm going to think of this as having 19 14s, meaning 14 plus 14 plus 14 plus 14, blah, 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 blah. Well, that's really the same thing as doing 20 times 14, and then taking away 1 times 14. Because really, we're supposed to only add 19 of them. So, but we're going to add 20 of them together. So we're going to multiply by 20. And then we're going to subtract 1 because we multiplied by too much. So 20 times 14, that's 280. 1 times 14 is 14. Now 280 minus 14 is 266, and there is our answer. And really, we should do square feet. And that is our lesson 4 for module 2, fifth grade module 2.